Hello, welcome to the video lecture series on mineral metabolism. In this video lecture, we will discuss about potassium. Potassium is a major intracellular cation and it is equally important in the extracellular fluid for specific functions. It plays a vital role in the cellular metabolism. Let's see the biochemical functions of potassium is the electrolyte, and hence it helps to maintain the intracellular osmotic pressure. It is required for the regulation of acid base and water balance. The enzyme pyruvate kinase, which is one of the enzymes in the glycolysis pathway, this enzyme is dependent on the potassium. Potassium is required for the normal action potential inside the nerve cell. Adequate intracellular concentration of potassium is necessary for proper biosynthesis of proteins by ribosomes, and extracellular potassium influences cardiac muscle cell activity. Daily requirement of potassium is about 3 to 4 grams per day. The various sources of potassium are banana, orange, pineapple, potato, beans, coconut water. The potassium is absorbed from the gastrointestinal tract, and it absorbs near about 90%, and very little is excreted in the feces. Normal plasma concentration of potassium is near about 3.4 to 5 milliequivalent per liter. The whole blood concentration is much higher, and it is near about 50 milliequivalent per liter. The higher concentration in whole blood, it is because the potassium is a intracellular cation. The excretion of the potassium is mainly carried out through urine. The mineralocorticoid hormone aldosterone increases the potassium excretion through urine. Let's see various disease states of potassium. The decrease in a potassium concentration is recognized as hypokalemia, whereas increased concentration of potassium in plasma recognized as hyperkalemia. Let's see first hypokalemia. Serum potassium concentration is recognized as hypokalemia. It is observed due to overactivity of adrenal gland, that's recognized as Cushing syndrome, prolonged cortisone therapy, IV administration of potassium-free fluids, treatment of diabetic coma with insulin, and prolonged diarrhea and vomiting. The symptoms are irritability, muscular weakness, tachycardia, cardiomegaly, and cardiac arrest. There is a changes occurred in the ECG of hypokalemic patient. The T wave, it get inverted and also flattened. Let's say hyperkalemia. The potassium serum concentration is hyperkalemia. It occurs due to renal failure, adrenocortical insufficiency, that is Addison's disease, diabetic coma, severe dehydration, and administration of intravenous fluid with a high potassium concentration. The symptoms are CNS depression, mental confusion, numbness, bradycardia, and cardiac arrest. The ECG of hyperkalemic patient is elevated T wave observed. If you like this video, then do not forget to subscribe to the channel. Till then, happy learning. Bye bye.